या लाइव? गुड इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग एंड वेलकम एवरीवन डियर टीचर्स, स्टूडेंट्स एंड द स्पीकर ऑफ द डे मिस्टर पुंडलिक कविराज. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, I feel privileged to announce Learn From Home webinar series for other medium schools following My English Course Book 10, organized by MNET with the technical support of INET Connect, featuring speakers like Dr. Manjushree Sardeshpande, the chairperson of the Board of Studies, Balbharti, Pune, Mr. Nadeem Khan, academic coordinator of CHESS, RA, Aurangabad, and Board of Studies member, Balbharti, Pune, Mr. Avinash Rade, Board of Studies member, Balbharti, Pune, Mr. Mahesh Dudhankar, Board of Studies member, Balbharti, Pune, Mr. Bhuvanesh Kumbhar, Board of Studies member, Balbharti, Pune, Mr. Pundalik Kaviraj, Board of Studies member, Balbharti, Pune, State Resource Person of CHESS, RA, Aurangabad, Mrs. Nandini Bhatkar, State Resource Person of CHESS, RA, Aurangabad. Learn From Home webinar series has started from 31st of August 2020 and is going to continue till 17th of September daily, except Sundays at 7 p.m. This series will provide a wonderful platform to know and understand your English activity sheet. I request all our participants to be a part of this series that would guide you to deal with your English activity sheet according to the state board norms and criteria. And today we have with us Mr. Pundalik Kaviraj. He is a secondary school teacher working at Mahatma Jyotiba Phule High School, Ashti Taluka, Chamorshi District, Gadchiroli. He works in the remote tribal area of Gadchiroli District. He has worked as a resource person for ELIS and BC, British Council RMSA, mentoring projects. He is a Board of Studies member, Balbharti, Pune. He is also the state level resource person for CHESS project. Today, he will deal with question number 2A and 2B and question number 4A, that is seen and unseen passages. I welcome you, sir, and I request you to take over from here. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Hello all, good evening. It's a pleasure to be with all of you. I hope we'll have a good time with each other. So, without wasting more time on the introduction or something else, we'll speak today. Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir, yes, sir. You're audible, sir.
Okay. So today we are going to deal with seen and unseen passages. How many participants are there? They're still to join, I think. Ma'am, should we start?
Yeah, we have to start, sir. We'll begin.
Okay. So, in this activity sheet, the question of... Okay. Just a minute, ma'am. Let me match the share screen.
Slide share, sir. You can put it slide share.
This is okay. It's okay.
So you can make the screen big on a slide more.
Is it not looking big?
Yeah, no.
So let me
sir,
see.
Down that cup is there. You can make it big.
Pundalik sir, you can go to the slideshow and start slideshow.
Slideshow.
PK sir, you can even press the button F5 there.
Just a minute, ma'am.
You are muted now, Pundlik sir. Yeah,
yes,
that's
sir.
Fine. Pundlik sir, you have to unmute yourself.
So you have to unmute yourself.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Is it okay now?
Yes, sir.
Shall I speak L1 also, if it is necessary? Hello.
Yes, sir.
No, thank you, sir. You can, Pundlik sir, you can continue.
Okay.
Palash. देखना बेटा मामा क्या बोल
बोला है ना.
ओके ओके शैल वी स्टार्ट.
यस सर.
सो टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज डीलिंग विद टेक्सुअल पैसेज एंड आल्सो नॉन टेक्सुअल पैसेजेस. So in our activity sheet, these passages are very important for us, as we can get or we can score maximum marks. As you know, there are not very big answers to write, so we can easily score all the 30 marks from these textual and non-textual passages. And these passages test our reading skills, grammar, and vocabulary. Reading skills means how we can understand, read and understand the passage and the facts and the gist of those passages. So these passages are there to test our reading skills, grammar, and vocabulary also. And also they check our critical thinking also in the form of these personal response questions. So, as you know, the first question is on language study, and second question, there are two textual passages. So, this passage, every passage has five questions bearing two marks each. It means that one passage is for 10 marks, and two textual passages and two non-textual passages. Means we can get 30 marks. So we should try to get all the 30 marks from this passages. So today we are going to see how we can score maximum marks in these two questions. So let us see. Means what kind of questions we have there based on the passages. So there are A1, A2, A3, A4, and A5. A1 is a simple factual activity. It's for 2 marks. A2 is complex factual. We'll see it in detail after this. So complex factual activity, 2 marks. Third activity, A3 activity is based on vocabulary for 2 marks. A4 means activity based on grammar, 2 marks, and A5 personal response question also for 2 marks. So there are some tips to excel or to score maximum marks in these passages. So the first tip is read the passage carefully, double read if necessary. What I think is, before reading that passage, if you have a look at first two activities, that means A1 and A2, it will help you while reading passage, because we have those points in our mind. So reading passage carefully is very important, because the purpose of these passages is to check your reading skills. So read the passage carefully, and if possible, if necessary, you can read it again and again. And then read and understand the instruction of the activities. Means we should exactly know what we should write. Means we should read the instruction and understand the instruction properly. That is very important. So let us see what simple factual activities are. Means these questions are there to pick up factual information from the passage through skimming. Skimming is a quick reading. So, and these activities are based on facts actually. Generally it is based on a single fact. Means we have to find out the facts. And for finding simple facts, we need not read it minutely, but for further questions, we have to read it minutely. But even looking at the passage, having a quick read and skimming, you can find out the facts asked in that activity. So the tips are, activities should be answered in the same format as asked in the question. What happens? Students read it, they understand the instruction, but write the answer in it. That is not the proper way of answering these questions. You should answer them in the same format, how it is asked. Means the format, the layout should also be the same. And you should write this sentence, these statements which are given in these activities in full statements. What happens, many times there are statements, the students write only one word as answer. It's okay, but we should try to write the whole statement. Like fill in the blanks, complete the following, arrange the sentences. For arrange the sentences, they tend to write 2, 3, 4, 1, like this. That is not a proper way. You should write those sentences in, means write the full sentences in proper order, and also choose the correct alternative. This is simple factual question. So what kind of questions will be there in A1, simple factual questions? It may be true or false, right or wrong, agree or disagree, fill in the blanks, complete the following, answer in one word or two words, match the following, name the following, and arrange the sentences in proper order, choose and collect. Choose the correct alternative, find through who said to whom. So such type of questions are there. So this is simple factual question. Just a minute, there is some problem. Not working properly. Okay. Now, A2, complex factual activities. Complex factual activities are not only to pick up factual information, but also to understand the meaning between the lines. I hope we have come across this term, reading between the lines, means understanding it thoroughly, means to understand what the author, the narrator, is trying to say. that's very important. So when we read it properly, means we have to scan the passage for this this activity. You should know what exactly he wants to say. So the proper understanding of the text is needed to deal with this activity. So you need to scan the text and try to understand the gist of that passage and what the author wants to say. And also, these activities should also be answered in same format as asked in the question paper. You cannot change the form. So you should answer them as they're asked. And many students ask this question, should we draw the layout or that web? Should we use pencil or a pen? That's not a big question. You can use either pen or pencil. But write the words in with pen. For drawing that web, you can use pen or pencil. So the questions asked in this activity means A2, complex factual question. So there are questions like describe, narrate, write, arrange in proper sequence, give reasons, make a list of given instruction. Doublet questions sometimes in activity form are there. Find proof. So finding a proof means some statement is given there. You have to find the proof from that passage and write it. You can write a line or you can write a fact from that passage to give a proof. Agree or disagree with reasoning. Yeah, we had already discussed this question in A1. So there, agree or disagree only, you have to write agree or disagree. That's all. But in complex structural question, you have to do some reasoning and you have to justify your answer, why you agree or why you disagree. And there are some questions like complete the web, complete the chart, sometimes explain why. But generally there are questions in the form of web. So let us see one example. So we can have the questions like this, activity, this web diagram. So complete the web, Kailash Satyarthi appeals. So there are, in that passage, there will be let us do this, let us do that. What appeals he makes there? You have to find out them and write it. So my suggestion is that if a web diagram is like this, you should also draw these circles and write in that form. Now A3. It's based on vocabulary. And vocabulary activities means you have to understand the meaning of those words in that context, in that given context. Otherwise, we know that words have different meanings, but what exactly that word means in that passage, we should know it. So it takes the deep knowledge of language. So you should be careful about, because there may be some confusing words. You may find more than one word which you think can be the answer. You should exactly know which word is the answer. There are different types of activities in this question, in this activity. And also, activities should be answered in the same format as asked in the activity. It applies for all the activities. So the topics for vocabulary questions may be synonyms, antonyms. Yeah, many times students are confused about synonyms and antonyms. They know some words of similar meaning and opposite meaning, but they are confused with these terms. Synonyms means words of similar meaning, and antonyms, as we see, anto, anti. Anti means opposite. Anti. So when we see anto, you should know its opposite, antonym. Old English words, sometimes old usage. So there are some questions in this section, means A3 vocabulary question. There may be some English words used in the passage which are not used nowadays, but they had been used in old English. Now we should know homographs, homophone, homograph. When we say graph, it's about spelling and writing. So there are some words which have same spelling but different meaning, different sounds also. For example, wind, wind, like that. Homophones, as we know, the words having same sound. There is code questions also. Code mixing here means in English passage, you can see, or many times we see some words from other languages used for Marathi words or any other words from any other language. For better effect, authors use them. For example, he wants to say that a paithani, like that, is a kind of type of sari, you know. So we cannot have English word for paithani. So they use paithani words. So sometimes there are questions like find non-English words or any other words from other language. That is code mixing. There may be questions on suffix, prefix. There may be questions on compound words, collocations, for crossword puzzle also. So in A3, collocations also means collocations means the words which generally come together. Collocations. There is confusion between collocations and compound words, but collocations are different words which come together generally. Now, A4, grammar in context. So A4 is a grammar question, and that checks, okay, there is some typo. It's deep knowledge, should be deep knowledge of language. So for ages, we are considering grammar as a non-language activity or what. We look at it as a math. Teachers teach them all the rules. Students learn them, the rules. And they solve these questions like maths problems. But we should understand that grammar is nothing but the use of language, how language works. That is grammar. That's why you see, the first question is not a grammar question. It's a language study question. No? So, actually, we are studying language when we solve grammar questions, when we are learning grammar. So, we should look at it as we are learning language better, in a better way. So, it's not rules and everything. Okay, we should know the rules. Grammar means rules, okay, but we cannot learn grammar in isolation. Grammar is language study. So we should understand the sentence and we can make necessary changes because we learn rules. Okay. Again, activities should be answered in the same format as asked and answer in full statements as far as possible. So what topics will be there? Because there is a separate question on grammar and vocabulary, language study question. It's the section 1. But there are grammar questions three passages means for 2 marks each. There are grammar activities for 6 marks altogether. All total means 3 passages, 6 marks. So there will be questions on tenses. Means identify the tense or change the tense according to the instruction. So tenses are there. The questions change the voice are there. Previously we had grammar questions. There would be some statement and under that there would be change the voice. But this question is asked in different ways. Means begin the sentence with this or any other type. So there actually it is change the voice. Direct and indirect speech. We know it. We will not learn grammar in this. We are only studying this activity sheet. So if you have any doubts about grammar, you can ask your teacher for that. Even you can ask me if you have any problem at the end. Direct and indirect speech, then degree questions are there. Identification and conversion of infinitive into gerund or vice versa means you have to miss a sentence is given and in which infinitive is used, you have to use the gerund form of that infinitive or vice versa. Means gerund is given there, you have to use infinitive form. Framing verbal or WH question. This is very easy, you know. And identification conversion of clauses. Students find it even difficult to teach and students find it difficult to understand, but it's not so difficult, clauses. If we pay some more attention, we can understand it. Generally, what happens in grammar, we don't try to understand the uses of language. We just know the rules. And grammar doesn't mean only the rules. We should know how words work, how sentences are constructed in different ways. So that is grammar. Saying the same sentence in different ways is a grammar. That's a language activity. And also there are questions on not only but also. Question tag, or it is called tail tag. This is also a very simple activity. You can score marks on it. Now, transformation of sentences means negative to informative or affirmative to negative. Then transformation, we learn 4 types of sentences. We have questions on them. Change into assertive sentence, change into exclamatory. Oh, there is one more type of exclamatory. It became exclamatory. Bear with that, please. So assertive to exclamatory, exclamatory to assertive, interrogative, assertive, imperative. There are different types of transformations. For that, we should know exactly what that sentence is, what an assertive sentence is, what an interrogative sentence is. If we know it properly, we can transform it. Then there is the use of modal auxiliaries. Modal auxiliaries. People generally pronounce it model. It's not model auxiliary, it's modal auxiliaries. So there are articles, prepositions, and punctuation type questions there in this question A4, that is grammar. Now, it's A5, the last question on all the passages, whether it is seen passage or unseen passage. A5 question or B5 question is personal response question. So what is there in this type of question? In our my area, generally, many students tend to skip this question. They don't even read it. They think that we cannot write answer to this question. Or sometimes they write some lines from the passage for this question. Generally, personal response question wants to know what you think. It's what do you think? Means there is a scope for self-expression, means expressing your own ideas, your reactions, maybe sometimes your imagination and your reasoning. It's not that every time you should write a positive answer. You can also be, you can also disagree with that, but you should justify your answer, whatever you write. So there is a lot of scope creativity in this question. So actually there is no right answer or no wrong answer in personal response question. Everyone should write it. Everyone should try it and write something. What do you think? Means, otherwise, in all other activities, you write the facts from the passages, you write something else. But here, in this question or in this activity, A5, you have the opportunity to express yourself. But in this question, the most asked question.
Excuse
me,
sir.
On this question means, yes, ma'am.
Sir, you are not audible.
I'm not audible?
Yes. Now a bit louder.
Okay. I'll see. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So for how long was I not audible?
Yeah, I got a comment, so I say. I call a 8-9.
Okay. I'll try to speak louder. So personal response question gives you an opportunity for self-expression. You can means you can express what you feel, because in the end, the question, the purpose of question is what you think. Means it takes your self-expression skill and your reaction, your critical thinking. So there is a lot of opportunity for creativity there. So everyone should try it. Okay. Mostly, the most asked question regarding this question, this activity is how much should we write for this question? So there are some teachers who tell them this is very important question. You should write, some students write the whole page answer, very long answer they write. But it's not necessary. Even you can complete your answer in 2 sentences. I'm saying sentences, not lines. 2 sentences can be in 4 lines or 5 lines, maybe in 2 lines. But you should complete, your answer should be convincing, and it should complete the idea, whatever you are expressing. So generally it is expected from the board that this question should be answered in 5 to 6 lines. 5 to 6 lines doesn't mean 5 to 6 sentences. So even if you write 2 sentences properly, proper sentences, it's okay. But they should be grammatically correct to get complete full marks. And your answer should be convincing. Means it should be clear that you are clear about that idea. You understood that idea and you expression what your point is. You should clear it. But then you will get full marks. And try to give evidence to support your response. Otherwise, you will say, okay, I do not agree with this. So you should support your answer. Why you do not agree? So this question is very interesting. So everyone should try it. So question types. So there are sometimes write, describe. There are some WH questions. Nowadays, generally, we find WH questions in personal response only. Then narrate, comment on that, explain. Sometimes there is question like, what would you do if you were in that place or something like that. Express your opinion about, justify the title of the story. Agree or disagree and why. Why is important. If you write yes, agree or disagree is not enough. You should write why you agree or why you disagree. And then there are questions based on your personal experience. So there are a few beginnings for personal response. It means when you are giving personal response or when you are writing answer to this question, you can generally begin like this. These are some suggestions. I completely agree with the fact that, or you can say I completely disagree with the fact. Okay, then you have to justify why you agree or disagree. You can begin with, in my opinion, like that. Then I strongly feel that. And you can also begin with, as we are aware that, something like that. And also you can say, as a famous saying goes like this, according to this famous saying, this is like that. So beginning with thesis, you can write proper answers to this or the personal response question. There is a B, question B for unseen passage, but we are not discussing it here.
Excuse me.
Yes, ma'am.
Little louder, sir.
I'm speaking very loudly, ma'am.
Okay, sir.
Keeping this mic very close to my mouth.
Okay, yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
I'm not audible. Oh, yes, ma'am.
No, I got some comments. Neat aikala yet nahi. So I just said. From the students.
खूप मोठ्याने बोलतोय आता आणखी ओरडाव लागेल मला मग काही प्रॉब्लेम असेल मॅम नेटवर्कचा की काय पण
चालेल
I am speaking very loudly.
Yes, sir.
Okay, ma'am. So that is the last activity we have discussed. So we have I completed it first because so that we can take more questions from the students. Hello, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
So,
yes, sir.
That's all with that. Let us take questions from our students or other participants. That's why I completed it earlier.
Okay.
So that we can take more questions.
Because there's one question that has come, sir. Sir, give some examples of collocation.
Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Please, sir. Stop sharing the screen.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Hello, sir. Sharing the screen.
Yes, sir. Nadim sir is saying something.
Stop sharing the screen.
Yeah, sir. Yes, stop sharing.
Yeah. Fine now.
I cannot hear you now.
Sir, now you can hear me. Yes, sir. Sir, you can hear me.
Okay, I'll speak. Okay. I can hear you.
Sir, there's one question that has come. Give me some example of collocation. They want
examples of collocation.
Yes.
Like a cup of tea. A cup of means generally we use a cup of tea. It can also be a collocation. Or I'm thinking. You can also give answers, ma'am. If you think of any
cold coffee is also an example of collocation that has come into cold recent coffee. Usage spiral binding, that's also an example of collocation. Mentally
loud
retarded
applause.
Learning disabled
retarded. Yes,
so all these are
as I said loud applause.
Yes, loud applause, crowning glory. So all these are the example of collocation. Lush green.
The words which generally mountain. Come together.
Yeah. They have come into recent usage.
Yeah.
Any other questions to students? Homophones example so also.
Homophones. Homophones means the words which may have different spellings but the same sound. For example, S-E-E-C, S-E-A-C, like that. And more examples are like hair, H-A-R-E, hair, H-A-I-R, hair, means the words which have same sound. Homophone, phone means sound. Homo means same. The words which have same sound. They are different words, but they have different spellings also, but they have same sound. So those are homophones. So there, I think we mentioned it in vocabulary activity.
Yes. In the language study.
There is a question of write the homophones from the passage.
Yes.
Or some words can be given there, and you write your own homophones those words.
Like flower, flower, B. The spelling?
B.
Yeah, seems to be different, but the sound remains the same. Mm. So they also want some example of code mixing.
I had already given, when I was explaining it, and I used that word paithani. So when in English text, when you find words from another language, so that kind of question is called as code mixing. For example, find the non-English words from the passage, or find Marathi words used in the passage, like that. Code mixing means while dealing with something in a language, when we use words of different language, that is code mixing, language mixing actually. So in our textbook also, there are in so many lessons, there are words which are not English words. So the writer uses different words from different languages, that is code mixing. And in vocabulary section, such questions appear there to find out the words from the passage which are not English words.
So that they celebrated Diwali. Mixing. Diwali is an Indian festival. Diwali is
Indian festival. And we cannot expect an English word for Diwali. The festival of lamps. That cannot be as effective as Diwali. Festival of colors, okay. But there is not a perfect single word in English. We cannot expect English word for those Marathi or Hindi words. So narrators use them. And that's code mixing.
So they just want to know something about clauses. But students, yesterday it was dealt with how to identify clauses.
So for that we need one complete session. Otherwise, within a minute I cannot tell about clauses. As you know, there are three clauses. Means there are two type of clauses, main clauses and subordinate clauses. So main clauses have no type. It's only main clause, but subordinate clauses can be a noun clause or adjective clause, or it can be adverb clause. And also there are different types of adverb clauses. So we cannot discuss all of them within 1 or 2 minutes. So better you ask your teacher, or we can have another session on clauses if it is possible.
Yes, sir. Any other questions, students? So, sir, I cannot see any other questions.
I thought they all have so many questions, so I completed early. Otherwise, have they any doubt about personal response question?
They had asked about personal. Means how to go about personal response questions.
How to go about? a big question, but we can say, okay, read the question properly and understand what that question expects from you. It's generally, as I said earlier, what you think on that topic or that issue. Means, do you agree with that, or do you not agree with that? Or what is your opinion about it? What do you think? Many times there is a question, what would you do if you were in that place? If what would you do if something like that happens with you? So then we have to express ourselves. We should write our own answers. That question is related to that passage, the topic of that passage. But sometimes we get answer to that question from the passage, but many times you do not get answer from the passage. You have to give your personal opinion. Personal, what do you think? Whatever you think is okay, but you should justify your answer.
Give one example of personal response question. That is by
related with the passage.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you think it is good to have or crack the crackers while Diwali? Or there may be a statement, we should not blow these crackers and this and that during Diwali. Do you agree with that answer, that statement? Some people may say, no, I do not agree because it causes pollution, noise pollution, air pollution. It's not good for our health, so we should not use all these things. So I think it's not good to have these crackers and all these atishbazi. There may be some people who would say, yes, there should be crackers in Diwali. Otherwise, there is no maja or no joy in Diwali. So for ages, we are using that. We are celebrating Diwali with crackers and other lightings. So we should use them. Otherwise, they will say only when it comes to Diwali, you are saying it's causing pollution. And there are so many other things which cause pollution and you are doing nothing about it. It's their own opinion. They can write like that.
Okay.
Want any other example? What would you do to keep yourself fit?
Yes, sir.
So you should write. Yes, ma'am.
Continue, sir.
Hello.
Yes, continue,
yeah,
sir.
Very, very, very well explained, Pundlik, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, and thank you very much for this session. Renu, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, vote of thanks, please.
Yes, sir. I request, sir, it was a very, very interactive session and very well explained. I request Khan Samina, ma'am, to propose a vote of thanks.
Ma'am is not audible. She should unmute herself.
Yeah, Samina ma'am, unmute yourself. Or Renu ma'am, you can unmute her.
Yeah.
Please.
Yes. Yeah. Am I audible now, ma'am?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you very much. Good evening, everyone. On behalf of the members of MNET, I would like to thank Mr. Pundlik Kaviraj for volunteering his time and providing us with such an informative and engaging presentation on the topic of seen and unseen passages. The topic explained by you will be of immense help for the students, and I hope our students will surely apply all the details explained by you. I would also like to appreciate the constant efforts of Mr. Nadeem Khan for providing the necessary technical support to MNET. Many thanks to the host and convener, Mrs. Renu Dhotre, for organizing the series of webinars, Learn From Home, through the platform of MNET. These webinars have enabled the students to stay updated with their knowledge and can be utilized by them. I would like to extend our thanks to the participants for the effectively participating, for effectively participating in the Learn From Home series webinars held till date. We look forward to such enthusiasm from our participants in the future as well. Once again, a huge thanks to everyone. Have a great evening. Stay home, stay safe.
Thank you so
much. I would also like to thank all of you. Renu ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you for, I would like to thank you for making this possible. Otherwise, because, okay, what is, but I could do it. And all because of you, you gave me this opportunity of interacting with all our friends. So I am grateful to you and Nadim sir and all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Pandalik sir.
Thank you, PK sir.
Thank you, Nadim sir.
Thank you, PK.
So I have a session now.
Thank you.